My name is Etienne Guérard. I am from Grenoble in France, and I'm coordinating the Green Diamond Project. So our planet is facing an energy crisis. We have to consume less energy, also use it more efficiently, reducing the losses between the power plant and the user. So we also have to use more renewable energy coming from the sun and the wind compared to the traditional energies. Each house could be one power plant. And we have to distribute all this energy coming from all these power plants all over the countries. And so the distributing system that we call the grid has to be improved. To control the flow of energy, we have to build power electronics that will reduce the losses in the control flow and also to dissipate as less as possible electrical energy. And that's the aim of the Green Diamond Project, to build a new power electronics that will be much more efficient and save energy.
Transistors are semiconductor devices that can be used to amplify a signal or as a switch that you find in almost present-day appliances like phones, laptops. These devices are very, very important and they form the heart of modern-day electronics. Diamond MOSFETs are presently being studied as an alternative to the silicon carbide technology design. The realization of diamond MOSFETs will be a competitive device in terms of electrical performance to the present-day silicon carbide.
Diamond, that's interesting because diamond is theoretically the best material for high power electronics. That's due to the fact that the breakdown voltage is highest, the mobilities of electrons and holes are very high, the thermal conductivity of diamond is high. So the overall properties of diamond are so good that if you can work with a semiconductor, you would definitely choose diamond.
Hello, I'm Tanya from Chemitronics from Cambridge in the UK. The Green Diamond Project brings together a consortium with different skills and experiences, with teams specialized in simulation, fabrication, characterization from both academic and industrial partners. Using state-of-the-art computer modeling techniques, we generate virtual models of the devices. This allows us to test parameter permutations and optimize the design of the diamond transistors. Based on the simulation predictions, we then manufacture prototype devices. They are afterwards characterized, giving us a better understanding of the trade-offs related to material properties and geometries we have used. This new knowledge is then fed back to the modeling team. Experimental results allow us to refine our models for better accuracy, leading to the most optimal diamond transistor design. This iterative design, fabrication, and characterization process will take our state-of-the-art technology to the next level in the coming years, ready for our industrial partners to deploy it and make more energy-efficient products.
Grow diamond. there's under extremely high temperature and extremely high pressure, like it is in the mantle of the Earth where diamond forms naturally. But there's another way that you can grow diamond. We take a chamber of some kind and we excite it with some electromagnetic energy, pump all of the air out of it, and then we flow in just a very small amount of methane and hydrogen atoms, so that for every carbon atom that hits the surface, what we get is either it leaving the surface etched away by the hydrogen or incorporated as a diamond. And so we grow it up a layer at a time, then adding in a couple of additional types of gas into the mixture too. And this gives us dopants. So if we want to grow diamond that has p-type connectivity, so this is diamond that's got an extra amount of positive charge, we take boron, and we do the same thing for negative type diamond or n-type diamond with phosphorus. And with those two types of diamond, we're able to make all kinds of interesting high power devices.
As there's a lot of power to be somehow dissipated in this kind of devices, I think it's very important, especially for the packaging in this sense of the diamond-based devices. We need something like a ceramic, something like a metallic matrix composite that could dissipate this power. The device has to cycle, and we need to really tailor the materials for the CT mismatches and to passivate somehow on top of the device. There are a number of encapsulants, but all of them are based on polymers. And polymers above 250 degrees, they start to deteriorate. So we really need to select something that could work at 300 degrees, and all this make the device burn out.
Taking on a challenging roadmap to deliver a groundbreaking 10 kilovolt transistor with novel packaging for operation at high temperature for the future European smart grid. The Green Diamond project, with its 15 partners from 6 countries, is funded by the European Commission Horizon 2020 research program, promising more breakthroughs, discoveries, and world firsts by taking great ideas from the lab to the market.